Well, that's the commercial, but what's the reality? I'm now 2,500 miles in on my RC520. So how's it been going? In this video, I'll take you through my impressions of the bike, how things have been going for me, any problems I've had. One of the components I thought might be a problem is the cassette. It's not the 105 cassette. Everything else is 105 apart from the crank, but the cassette is microshift. I have to say I've been pleasantly surprised. The shifting's smooth. I don't find it as easy to index as the 105. And when it's time to have a new cassette, I'll be going for the 105, but I'll be going for the 105 1134, which will give me a bit more climbing ability. This one is the 1132, which is still fine, but if you're going up some of the steeper climbs, then I think the 34 will do me well. Another component that needed to stand the test of time was the mechanical hydraulic disc brakes. So just a reminder, these are a hydraulic piston and they are connected to the shifters with a Jaguar cable. Now, of course, fully hydraulic brakes will adjust to pad wear. But with this brake, you'll find that if you do get a bit of slack on the lever, all you need to do is tighten up the cable slightly. Very, very simple. The other good thing about it is that they've not skimped on the quality of the cable, so the outers don't compress at all. Therefore, you get direct braking action. Now, I've just changed the pads on this. I didn't really need changing. They were wearing unevenly, so I decided to change them when I changed the ones on the Ribble. And I've now put a ceramic pad on, very cheap to replace, about £14 to do the whole bike, and very easy to fit. I've heard it said that you have to take the calipers off to change the pads, but that's just not true. You have to loosen one of them slightly, but you've got to do that anyway to adjust them after you've fitted them. So it's absolute doddle. It was only after I realized the off-road capability of this bike that I decided I would upgrade the tires. I had 28 mil gator skins on, which were great, but a pig to get on and off. Now I've swapped them for the marathons I've taken from the Ribble, and I've put new Continental Contact Plus on the Ribble. And I have to say, these tyres went on a heck of a lot easier than the gator skins. And the other big thing is that they do come off pretty well. Another part of the spec that aids comfort is the thick bar tape. And also we've got carbon forks. So the carbon forks are providing some shock absorption, as is the wide bar tape. And it is a very comfortable bike. My longest ride on this bike is 153 miles. And I was still comfortable at the end of it. In fact, I've achieved 4 century plus rides on this bike. It's certainly a go anywhere bike, as I've said. As you can see, we can go off road quite easily and it's just as at home on the road. Another big benefit is if you want to go and do some bike packing, you can just put some panniers on. And as you can see here, you've got all the fittings you need for front panniers and a rear rack. So the bike really is well equipped, and when you consider the spec you're getting for under £1,000, it's incredible. If you've watched my videos before, you'll know that I'm more interested in distance riding and comfort riding rather than high speeds, but there's no reason why this bike can't give you high speed if you keep it as light as possible. I mean, it comes out at, I think it's about 10.4 kilos. If you look at my previous video, you'll see the weight of the bike as I had it before. I've made it heavier because I want it to have this all-round capability of on and off road. But if you want to keep the bike as light as possible, you could just go with the original tyres. You could go tubeless and keep the bike as light as you can. And you've got a good speedy machine. Decathlon in their advertising say that you can put up to a 36mm tyre on. These are 35, so I've got one here now. And as you'll see, there's plenty of room. That might be a bit tight getting a mud guard on at that, but it's not a problem. I'll just go back and stick the gator skins back on. Come on, you come through.
I should have gone that way than that way.
Yeah.
Cheers, mate.
You're welcome. This bike has certainly taken some punishment. I slipped off once on some ice quite hard, and then I was hit by a car in the town. It was a slow speed hit, but it still knocked me off. And as you can see, the bike has got some battle scars from it. Now, had I been on my previous carbon bike, I think it would have been game over for the bike. But as it was, you can see here, we've just got a few scars and we're up and running. I managed to ride the bike home to straighten the handlebars and we were off. Anyone can sell you a bike, but customer service and support's another thing often. And I have to say, I've been very impressed with Decathlon. I've had no problems with the bike at all, but I contacted them before I made this video just to ask if they could give me a few photographs that I could use. They were absolutely superb. Not only did they send me some photographs, they sent me the video that you saw at the opening, and they've actually given me a contact who's a technical man, and he's answered a few questions for me. So top marks to Decathlon. In my original review, I said that it was great value if you could get over the idea that it was a Decathlon brand. Well, frankly, that's not an issue anymore. I found the bike gets admiring glances, and people often ask about the spec, and they're quite incredulous when they see exactly what you get for the money. Now, if you don't want to get your super carbon bike dirty and ruined in the winter, then this would make a great winter bike, especially with the high spec. Or, like me, just use it all year round. Hiya. I've told you plenty of what I like about the bike, but what don't I like? Well, I suppose the only thing is the colour. It's okay, but I think Decathlon would do well to actually bring some other colours into the range. I've had one or two people say they would like it, especially some of the ladies who say, yes, I like it, but I'd like a different colour. So it's just something for Decathlon to think about. I have often been, along with others, a critic of the wheels on the Triban. I've actually said they must be oversized because they are a pig to get the tyres on and off. Now, I had a word with somebody at Decathlon, a technical man, very knowledgeable. And he said, well, I have to argue, the wheels are not a different size to any other wheels. So I decided to test it. And you know, he was right. I compared them with the Mavics on the Ribble and they're identical. Where I think there is a problem is that it's tubeless ready and it does seem to grip the bead on the tyre. Now, the man at Decathlon suggested that it would be better to use a folding tyre, one without the stiff bead. Now, I happen to have some folding tyres available. They were the ones that were the OE equipment with the Ribble. And I put them on. They've never been on a bike before. And I have to say they were a lot easier. I still couldn't get them on with just my thumbs, but they were easy to get on even with a tyre lever. One of the problems recently has been supply. Demand for bikes is outstripping supply, and Decathlon have had the same problems that other manufacturers have had. But I've contacted Decathlon customer services in the UK on your behalf, and they are now giving me a monthly stock expectation list, and I'll pin that to the top of the comments. Obviously, if you want one of these bikes, you need to get in fairly quickly, but I'll keep doing this as long as they keep giving me the information. Although I'm getting you some stock figures for the UK, I can't do it obviously for the world. So if in your country you want to know the stock position, just ask customer services at Decathlon and I'm sure they'll oblige. So thanks for watching. I'm going to leave you with some video we took on a joint YouTubers ride. I rode the towpaths of the Birmingham canals with Wheelers at Large, Paul Green Vlog, and Ricky Lake. We had a great day. I'm sure some of you have seen their videos. If you haven't, I'll put links below to their channels. Here's just a few clips of us on the ride. And what I would ask you to note is that I was using the RC520 on that day. And you'll also see ahead of me in some of the shots is Mike Wheeler, who's also using a Triban. So hope you enjoy it, and I'll see you next time. Thanks for watching. Big hole, big hole, very big hole. Right, here we're on our Birmingham Canal ride today, and so we've got Paul Green and Paul Green Vlog. We've got Ricky Lake.
Hey, how you doing?
And then we've got the Wheelers at Large.
Very much at large.
Yeah, they're very much at large.
They're miles from here today.
Yeah. I forgot to download my route, so Paul has been navigating.
Well, we say we use that term loosely.
Very loosely. Yeah. But we eventually got here. We were all very hungry, so we're just in Gas Street Basin now. At the Pitcher and Piano, and we're about to have a sumptuous lunch. So we'll talk to you after lunch. Have you? It's worrying me that you've got the route. Yeah, so we're at the end of our ride. I've got 64 miles and Paul's got 67, so he must have gone a bit further than us.
I got lost more.
Yeah.
I was leading away when we got lost.
Yeah.
I'm in the middle, I got 62.
Well, I got 71 somehow, I don't know how.
All right.
Let's finish.
Richard, what have you got?
I have got...
Yours will be in kilometres, won't it?
117 kilometres.
You're in that foreign stuff.
I had to ride here as well.
Of course. And you've got a ride back. So it's been a great day. We've seen a lot of Birmingham that we didn't know existed, all the backwaters, literally. It started raining towards the end, but the weather forecast last week was for rain all day, so we've been really lucky with the weather. So hope you enjoyed that, and talk to you soon. Bye.